I had been noticing that my students were really challenged after COVID on campus, mentally, emotionally, and the aftermath from being away from campus, along with a lot of the global issues that are happening right now, have really not helped students feel connected with themselves, with content sometimes, each other, et cetera. And so I really feel like there's a need for more experiential coursework that reconnects students with the physical world. I grew up building boats. I built my first boat with my father when I was 15 and really was transformed by that experience and knew that there had to be a curriculum piece in there for my students as well. And I've always enjoyed designing curriculum that's risky, you know, that's novel, that involves some intellectual or pedagogical risk to me and to the students. With those ideals in mind, I developed this course to combine building a physical product like a boat with the study of some of my favorite ecosystems, which happen to be wetlands. I wanted the students to develop some basic woodworking skills because I think, A, the profession of environmental science requires that of students if they're in the field, and B, I think that it builds some really important characteristics for our students today. I think it builds pride, builds self-confidence, it builds resilience and grit, and it helps students learn how to collaborate and communicate with each other.
I had to learn how to use tools. I had to learn how to read plans. I had to learn how to move quickly. A fun part of building the canoes was just being able to do hands-on learning and just building. I've never built anything with wood like that before, and so it was a very new process. But it was a lot of fun waking up, going to class, and just starting off my day building a canoe and getting to work with different tools all the time and just working with a team throughout the whole semester.
We actually took the students down to Rockport on the Gulf Coast, and we used the boats to monitor a decade-long oyster reef planting that had occurred down there in town, and we're able to get out to where the oyster reefs were in the water and anchor the boats and use them as kind of platforms to measure length, size of individual oysters within specific transects, as well as calculate the overall length and width of the oyster bed and how it had grown or not grown over the last 10 years.
When you learn about an oyster reef in a textbook, you don't really get the gist until you're out there at an oyster reef. So we were able to actually participate and provide data and research for the Rockport area, which is very cool and exciting that when you're doing field work, it's actually making a difference. It was also exciting getting to meet with Amy Belair and learn about her oyster farm. It was a really interesting experience because it opened my eyes to more career opportunities where I could actually go into sustainable entrepreneurship.
We did some wetland plant restoration by transplanting some Spartina grass species from one area to another where there was some erosion and some degraded ground. The value of that is that it will help re-establish a grass community in some of the most fragile ecosystems that we have down on the Gulf that are actually really important buffers from storms.
Being able to be out in the field, meet people who work in the field, different professionals, and talk with them, you're able to feel more encouraged and feel more empowered to pursue different interests that you have. And I know for sure that all of the field trips I've gone on have only solidified my interest in ecology work.
I hope students take away from this class lessons about what it means to use a tool in the world and how to problem solve when they're out in the field in their professions. I hope that they take away some self-confidence and some pride in the work that they've accomplished. I hope that they are able to learn how to communicate, collaborate, and become leaders in their field. I hope that they understand the value of working to save wetlands and the importance that those ecosystems play in protecting our planet, especially with the encroachment of climate change. And I hope that they remember and are able to take the transformation that they went through in this process and share that forward.